Okay, this video is supposed to be following Dr. Fowler's video regarding trigonometric functions. Why does trigonometry work? And also, I guess, why are the are there these other trigonometric functions? Basically, there are two purposes for trig functions. One is the one that Dr. Fowler alluded to yesterday, or alluded to in the other video, and that was to take advantage of similar triangles. So if we have an angle here, and we have another triangle, let's say, that has the same angle, these are both right triangles, then, for example, because they are similar here, we know that the ratios between two corresponding sides there on each one, so A over B and A prime over B prime, are the same thing. And we call those ratios, for example, this ratio here would be called the sine of theta. So the purpose of this trig function here, or this purpose of the trig functions here, is to really take advantage of that here. There is only one sine, say, of 53 degrees, or one sine of, say, pi over 5 radians. And we relate that number then to the lengths of the sides there. And so one purpose of trigonometric functions is to relate angle measure to length measure. And in doing so, we relate two completely different types of measurement here. Length measure is a physical measurement, measuring kind of how long or the distance. And angle measure measures something completely different, namely basically direction or rotation. If you don't have right triangles, certainly you might recall from school the law of sines and the law of cosines. And if you don't recall those, you might want to look those up because they may pop up a couple of times this semester. The other purpose of trig functions doesn't deal with geometry whatsoever. It comes from geometry, in which we extend the types of angles that we take the trig functions of via the unit circle. I'm going to be drawing a, of course, perfect circle here. And so, for example, here we can talk about the sine or the cosine or the tangent and so on there of an angle that's more than 180 degrees, more than an obtuse angle. And in doing so, particularly with sine and cosine, which I'm going to be mostly dealing with here, we know that sine at any point on this unit circle is the y coordinate. So let's say this is theta here. This is the first coordinate angle, but this could work for all of them. The y coordinate is the sine of the angle, and the x coordinate, how far over it is the same as the cosine of theta. So you might recall that from school. And in doing so, what we see is we could follow these trigonometric functions as functions themselves here as sine changes. So we can look at y or f of theta is equal to sine of theta. And when we put it on a graph relating theta to its trigonometric function sine theta here, we'll find here, and following the y coordinate, say theta is equal to 0 is right here, and we follow the y coordinates around the circle here, we will see the y coordinates sketching out, starting at 0 here, increasing through the first quadrant, decreasing through the second quadrant, keep decreasing through negative in the third quadrant, and then coming up still negative and increase up back to 2 pi. And then it would keep going here because we could rename these angles over and over again by adding 360 degrees or 2 pi to them. And so what we get here is we have a graph that models, that turns out to model many, many, many different physical phenomena here, such as, for example, the height of a pendulum as it swings as a function of time, or say the temperature, average temperature throughout the year here in Columbus as you go through. And of course, what you learned in school was we would take this basic graph of sine, for example, and shift it up, stretch it out, change the period of it here, change the amplitude, and so on there to fit those models. And I believe you may see a couple of those examples in the first chapter or so of your Briggs textbook in the exercises. So what happens now is we have these, basically we can take this theta here, cross it out, and replace this, say, with time as the temperature throughout the year, or say the height of the pendulum going. So what we have here is a somewhat an oscillating function here, going up and down and up and down and so on forever, in which has nothing to do with trigonometry, but it models a great deal of physical phenomena. Any wave motion whatsoever, any periodic phenomena, will probably, you'll see a sine and cosine function in there somewhere. So that completes the video of two purposes for trig functions. One, relating angle measure to length measure. The second, representing or modeling periodic behavior. Thank you very much.